This illustration is about analysis of a smooth rod sliding over a wedge. Here we are given that all surfaces shown in figure are smooth and the rod is constrained to move only in vertical direction due to the wall support C and D. It is saying if the system is released from rest, we are required to find the acceleration of the wedge, and we are also given that to take capital M is 4 times small m the mass of a rod. So, in this situation again, to analyze the motion of these bodies, we need to represent all forces acting on bodies on a free body diagram. So, let me redraw the figure. This is the wedge of mass m having inclined surface at an angle theta, and this is the rod which is smoothly placed on the wedge, which is supported by the support C and D. Here we can see, as the normal reaction between ground and the wedge is say N1, and a normal reaction act between the rod and wedge is say N2. Due to the horizontal component of force N2, the rod has a motion tendency toward right, which it will not move because of the support D. It will exert a force N3 onto it. A normal reaction is developed here. As the rod has a tendency to slide toward right, there won't be any contact force between support C and N3. However, we are not interested in horizontal motion of rod because it is already given to us that the rod is constrained to move only in vertical direction. Now, in this situation, if we draw the free body diagrams, say first we draw that of wedge A, then it will experience the downward weight, which is 4 mg, its mass is given as 4 times the mass of rod. Toward the leftward downward direction, this is the normal reaction N2, which is acting on it due to the rod, which is at an angle theta with the vertical, and a normal reaction N1 acting on it due to ground. And see, the wedge moves toward left with an acceleration A1 that is due to the horizontal component of N2. Now, if we draw the free body diagram of rod B, and here we can see downward its weight is acting, and one normal reaction due to the inclined plane N2 is acting on it, which is at an angle theta with the vertical, and a normal reaction here we can consider N3 due to the support D. Now, in this situation, the rod will move vertically with an acceleration A2. And first we can relate the values of A1 and A2 by a constraint relation. Like here you can see, when the rod will move vertically down by this distance, say Y, the wedge will move toward left by this distance X, because when wedge will move toward left by X, rod will come down with Y. So here we can write the value of tan theta as Y by X. So these distances would be proportional to the accelerations of the wedge and rod. So we can directly write the value of tan theta is equals to A2 by A1. So here we are getting the value of A2 acceleration of rod is equals to A1 tan theta. This is the relation we are going to use in equations of these bodies. So if we write equation of motion for leftward motion of wedge, here we can write the equation as N2 sin theta is equals to 4mA1, that is here first equation, as only due to N2 sin theta, this wedge will move toward left. And for rod, again, as it is going down, we can write its equation as mg minus N2 cos theta is equals to mA2. And the value of A2 we can write as A1 tan theta, that is here equation 2. And in these equations, if we substitute the value of N2 from here to here, we get the value of A1. So here we can write from equation 2, we are getting mg minus the value of N2 we can write as 4mA1 by sine theta. We are calculating the value of N2 from equation 1 and substituting here. So this is mA1 tan theta. Now, if we continue here, this equation, we can cancel the value of mass and simplify for A1. The value of A1 here we are getting is G divided by tan theta plus 4 cot theta. That will be the final result for the problem. I leave it for you to simplify this equation and get the result.